I'm in the bike graveyard. My trusty steed, the Claude Butler Trail Ridge 1.4.
Yeah, it's way too small. Here's the lake where the water sports takes place. Okay, we've come to the abandoned school today to shoot this block. So the other day I was sat at lunch and I was talking to a couple of my colleagues, and I had this GoPro out on the table because I'd just been using it to shoot some footage of me repairing some sun loungers, which is one of the things that I was just randomly doing that afternoon. And they asked me about it, why have you got this camera, what's it for? And we got talking, and eventually we did get into it, and I did reveal that I had a YouTube channel. Critically, I did not tell them really what the channel's about, and I didn't tell them the name of the channel, and I said to them, I don't want to tell you the name of the channel because then you might go and watch it and you'll find out all this information about me and form an opinion, basically, because this is a professional relationship I have with these people at this place. The big reason I wanted to start doing YouTube in the first place was the need for self-expression and self-exploration, to go within and see what was in there and to bring it out. Many of you will relate to this. In the early stages of the journey, you find it very difficult to express yourself to, you know, friends and family. I couldn't possibly share with them what I was going through, what I was experiencing. And the beauty of an outlet such as YouTube is that you can put your thoughts and feelings into words and pictures and just put it out there. And then the thing about it, and the reason I feel compelled to continue doing it, is that I no longer feel a need or a desire or a pressure to make myself understood to people face to face. I can just put it out there on YouTube, and if they watch it, they watch it. You know, I never made a big deal out of promoting my YouTube channel to people, I would say, from the past, you know, people who would be familiar with the old me before I started to wake up and branch out. And it's not important whether or not people acknowledge it. It's there. Sometimes I get comments pop up in the notifications which will take me back to videos that I made months or even years ago, and I'll go back and I won't respond to these comments because they're asking me questions about things I was thinking about and experiencing all that time ago. But sometimes I will watch the video and go, okay, let's see if I still stand by what I said back then. And I still do stand by the vast majority of it, although it can be very painful to go back and revisit concepts that you were experimenting with in the past. It's a beautiful thing to wake up and realize how different everything is from the way you used to think it was. But it's also a painful thing. There's a lot of letting go, and letting go can be painful. But you will see it as one and the same. Embracing the new is the same as letting go of the old. I could delete all my old videos, especially the ones I don't resonate with. I could stop making videos entirely and just have this experience privately. I suppose it's worth noting that 99% of the experience I am not documenting. I am just having it day to day. I tend to document the more interesting parts of it, the more exciting parts of it, which we all know is a roller coaster. There are peaks and troughs, and there are just great big flat bits where there's not really a lot going on. You're just living your life pretty much as an AI yourself. That's something I can completely relate to. You need to just get through the days, you need to function in society. But ultimately, the value of this experience, the sharing of the experience, cannot be put into words, and that's why I continue to do these things. I just want to admit publicly how lost I feel at times. And again, this is something everyone experiences at times, but we put a brave face on it, or we only show our face when we're not feeling that way. And what I'm saying here is I've gone back and I've looked at these videos where people have said, you know, what the fuck's wrong with you? And I'm looking at these videos like, yeah, you know, I made that video when I was in a really dodgy place. But it all leads to a deeper understanding of yourself. And if we follow the principle of as within, so without, it's a deeper understanding of the experience that we're having. Anyone who keeps a diary, you know that you record your darker days as well as you record the bright days, right? And the difference here with making it a vlog or a blog somehow is to share these things publicly, which is a form of self-sacrifice, and that is a form of service to the collective. So a lot of the time I watch other people on YouTube and I think, what is this guy's agenda? Yeah, he's saying these words right now, he's promoting this idea, but what ultimately is the thinking behind it? And then of course that leads me to look at my own YouTube output when I'm revisiting it and think, what is this guy's agenda? What is he ultimately trying to achieve here? And what I realize from having now this collection of videos that goes back maybe 2 or 3 years now, is that yes, there is a man who's doing these things and saying these things, but ultimately I am the observer behind these thoughts and actions. I am the energy which moves the puppet. I am the actor who is saying these lines. The deeper I try to dig to find a core truth of who I am, I keep coming up with nothing. It's like sand slipping through the fingers.
By exploring these types of thoughts, even though we always end up just spinning our wheels, we are temporarily getting away from the illusory self which we have in this lifetime, taken as the entirety of who and what we are. This is another way to see what psychologists call depersonalization disorder, which I spoke about in my previous video. Try choosing a word at random and repeating it over and over again until it loses all meaning. It won't take long, I assure you. Why does this happen? Because the word is not the thing. It is a symbolic representation, and a very poor one at that. The exact same truth is discovered when you consider what it means to be Mr. Whoever, Miss So-and-so, whoever you think you are. Only because it is in relation to yourself, it is far more tangible, far more profound to realize that this thing, this concept which you previously thought was you, has no definition. No boundary.
Ultimately, the end of this will be the resolution of the disharmony which begins within the individual when we start to wake up. It doesn't mean we're gonna magically fix the world, it just means that we're gonna become okay with feeling of being awake in a world which is still so soundly asleep. This will be the end of feeling mentally unstable, it will be the end of chronic physical illness. I don't know how it's going to look on the outside, and I don't really concern myself with that too much. What I'm concerned with is how it will feel and trying to manifest that feeling. And I'm concerned with how this transitional period that I'm currently in, I'm concerned with how that feels. A lot of the concepts and ideas that I've picked up and experimented with along the way, they will come back and I'll be able to use them again, I suppose, when the transition period ends. If there's one thing you take away from this, please let it be this. Remember, you are not losing your sanity. You are finding it for the first time in an insane and artificial world.